Hi there and welcome to this tutorial. Let's get started right away. And the first thing, you'll need to go to Blesta and download it for free. And the first month is free to try it. So just download it from Blesta. And my server setup is, I will be using HestiaCP. I'm using LAMP stack, the one with Apache. So if you don't want any problems, you want Blesta to work flawlessly, just do yourself a favor. Either use Litespeed, and I mean Litespeed Enterprise, or Apache with Nginx proxy. And that comes by default in HestiaCP. So you don't have to do anything to set it up. All you have to do is install Ioncube. The last video I did was about installing Ioncube. So make sure you have Ioncube loader working on your HestiaCP so that you can see this page. All right, now that that's out of the way, let's see how to install Blesta and then get started with setting up packages, setting up different things, and so on. So let's come in here and I will just refresh this so that I can show you what to do to install Blesta so that you can get to the same point as me. So I'm not going to do this again, but go to your file manager. If you're using HestiaCP like me, just open the file manager from there and then go into web. And then for the domain where you want to install Blesta, open it up and then go into public HTML. And then the Blesta version that you've downloaded from blesta.com, put that in there, just drag it in and then extract it. And the folder will be called Blesta and it will come with all these other items. The one thing that I've renamed is Blesta. It's called Blesta, but I've renamed it to account. So the folder is going to be on your server. Once you extract it, you'll see Blesta, but I've renamed it to ACC for account. So the domain was that, and then I'm going to install Blesta inside of ACC, right? So if you don't want to install it inside of a domain, you can just select everything inside here, go inside of the Blesta directory, select everything, and then move. And then just move, where is web? Okay, web. Click the plus button, keep searching for the domain you want. And now you probably want to put it inside there. So just click on that and it's going to move the files in there. But I don't want to do that. I'm just going to install it inside of that directory. So I'm going to come in here and just refresh the page. Everything is working fine. Make sure Ioncube is working. If install Ioncube correctly, like I showed you, and it's not working, make sure you restart PHP, or you can restart your entire server if you don't know how to restart PHP. So install via browser. Let's continue via browser. So first of all, I agree to the terms, indeed. And then recommended requirements. I can see that things are missing here. GMP extension is recommended for better performance. Now, I've used PHP a while, and I usually know most of these applications, most of these extensions, you can just get them via the package managers. So I'm running Debian. Is it Debian? Let me just do Shift Z Q. I think I'm running Debian here. Let me just confirm. Host name CTL. Yeah, you can see that's Debian. Okay. So I can try to do apt. If you're not the root, add sudo apt. I'm just going to try sudo apt install. Most of the packages are usually named like this. I'm probably wrong, but PHP 8. Is it PHP 81 or 8.1? What was the name of the package? GMP. Okay. Nice. One down. So we've installed PHP 8.1. GMP. So of course, install it for your PHP version. I'm using PHP 8.1. The MailPass extension is, I don't know whether it's called MailPass. Let's just see. Usually they're just named with a certain universal structure. Control Shift V. Okay, you can see that one is also named. All right, I'll do Control L to clear that screen and then let's refresh and hopefully we are now green. Okay, so everything is green. We have all the needed requirements. Now the next thing, let us set up a database on HestiaCP. I'm going to go into DB. So web mail. Go into DB, and then inside of DB, we are going to add database. I don't have any databases. I'll just call it Blest. And the name of your database will be that. then type MySQL, and then username. That will be my username. And then password, I can generate a password. And then after generating the password, you can email that to somebody if you want to. Let's see what advanced options we have. Host is local host. Yeah, I'll leave that as it is. And then I will save to create the database. Once the database is created, I can put the details in here. So database is that, database port is that. If you don't change the port, that's the default port. And then database name, that's our database name. Database user. And then the password. Install. All right. So we're just going to do a trial. So I'll select trial. So let's just do finish and see what's mandatory here. Okay. Please enter username and password. That's what's mandatory. So username, we can just say blessed user. Password, let's generate that, and then email. When I click finish, so I need a first name and last name. They should just tell you everything is mandatory. There you go. You're now inside of Blesta. So I can see there's something here. A system directory is not writable. Let's look at this. Which directory is this? So uploads is not writable. Logs.blesta is not writable. But these are things we can fix. Okay, why don't we try to set up the path fully? Let's add the full path. And then update the settings. Let me just define the logs to be the same path. Update. Oh, it's not writable because it doesn't exist. So maybe I should create this directory. Copy. I should create this directory inside here. New folder. Create. Let's come back, update settings. There we go. That's one problem down. Do you have another problem? Trial. The cron has never run. Generate. Update cron key. Run cron manually. Everything is working. The cron can run and you can see there. So these are things you just need to test to make sure that Blesta will work the way it is supposed to work. So after doing that, you can see everything is okay. Your trial, you can buy a license if you want to. So I don't want the video to be too long. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to split it. In the next video, we're going to do an overview of all these other elements and where you can do what in Blesta.